Hello tonight. Today is Thursday, February 17th, and we're doing our video blog, and we are still in Romans chapter 4. Today we're going to do verse 13, 14, and 15, and Paul is continuing to talk about faith. And I just want to, just before I get into these scriptures, it is all about faith. I mean, faith is the essence of why I'm sitting here right now. Faith is why you're sitting there right now as a believer, if you are one. If you're not one, faith is what is going to bring you into the kingdom of God. Faith, it's all about faith. Understanding the depths of faith, the depths of faith, and understanding what faith is, how faith functions. That's a big deal. So as you read through the New Testament, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, which are the Gospels, and then the book of the Acts of the Apostles, and then we're in Romans, which is Paul's major theological discourse, one of the probably the most systematic breakdown of the theology of the gospel of Jesus, and how it just breaks down the intricacies and some of the depths of what we're actually walking in as New Testament or New Covenant believers. But in verse 13, Paul says, clearly, God's promise to give the whole earth to Abraham and his descendants was based not on his obedience to God's law, but on a right relationship with God that comes by faith. This is absolutely huge. Remember, I want to read this verse 13 one more time. Clearly, God's promise to give the whole earth to Abraham and his descendants was based not on his obedience to God's law, but on a right relationship with God that comes by faith. That comes by faith. verse 14, if God's promise is only for those who obey the law, then faith is not necessary and the promise is pointless. For the law always brings punishment on those who try to obey it. The only way to avoid breaking the law is to have no law to break. So, verse 14 says, for God's promise is only for those who obey the law. If God's promise is only for those who obey the law, then faith is not necessary. And the promise pointless. Those are big words. Paul is basically saying, the law has no power to save you. It is by turning to God, saying, you know what, I believe in what you've done for me, and I'm going to receive your goodness, and I'm going to let your goodness transform me. See, this was always God's plan. From the beginning of the world, he wanted relationship with Adam and Eve. He wanted to be in the mix. He wanted to be their God and for Adam and Eve to be his people. But he had to let them choose. And you know what? He has to let us choose. We're in the same place right now where we can have access. We have access. We can have a relationship with God through faith, through simply believing and saying yes to him. We're back in the garden. Essentially, Jesus Christ made a way to bring us back into the paradise of God, which is his presence. We can go about our Father's business, doing good, healing all who are oppressed of the devil. As we have a relationship with him, and as we obey him, as we lay down our lives by faith, by obedience to God. Again, we're going to go through our whole Christian walks growing in faith. Hopefully you're going to grow in faith. Understanding, I know I'm growing in faith. I encourage you to grow in faith. But understanding the depths of what faith is. And Abraham, we'll get into that a little bit more tomorrow. God bless you and have an amazing day. We will see you again tomorrow, Friday.